Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here. I've done separate kind of previews of both these books, but I want to bring them together and show that in the late 19th century, early 20th century, some different philosophies and pseudoscience kind of got foisted upon Western culture, and how their influence, even among the intelligentsia, is beginning to wane. Now, not necessarily in the academic world. Academia and intelligentsia are two different things, and we won't really go into the differences of that. But I wanted to show you even, and we'll look at this too, the type of people who are recommending these books. So the first, you know, Charles Darwin, Victorian Mythmaker by A.N. Wilson, could have been written by a creationist. And then Freud, The Making of an Illusion by Frederick Cruz. Even The New Yorker said Freud, The Making of an Illusion is a stake driven into its subject's cold, cold heart. Cruz is an attractively uncluttered stylist, and he has an amazing story to tell. Now, of course, I wish I had time to read both these books. Lord willing, I will at some point in my life. But I used to read, you know, I try to read as I'm led of the Holy Ghost. And so recently, I've just been almost totally all in Scripture. And so God has taken me through times in my life where for years I would just read the Bible. And then other times He would say, I want you to read this book, this book, this book. Those that are led by the Spirit of God, those are the sons of God. Okay, so let's do for the praise for the Charles Darwin book, A Book to Treasure. A.N. Wilson throws down the gauntlet on the very first line. Darwin was wrong, he begins. What follows is a sharply observed and wonderfully compelling analysis that evokes the Victorian Titan brilliantly and challenges received wisdom, a work of scholarship that's hard to put down. That's by Deborah Cadbury. Book list, starred review. Though Darwin's all-encompassing theory is now widely regarded as paradigmic science, Wilson provocatively considers it a quasi-religious credo, like Marx and Engels, the Communist Manifesto, which would be the third of these philosophies hoisted on the West, ultimately doing more to shape political attitudes than advance scientific understanding. Kirkus reviews books, you know, that's major, says this: the prolific novelist and biographer probes the character and controversies of Charles Darwin's life and the controversial theory that turned the world on its head, an illuminating new biography of a legendary figure in the scientific world whose legacy continues to draw reappraisals. And so even Darwinism, you know, Darwin changed Darwinism, you know, from 1859 to 1871, The Descent of Man. And he saw there were some flaws, and then he kept thinking that the fossil record would come to his rescue, and now we know it hasn't. And when I talk to people about transitional fossils, it's like a preeminent evolutionary scientist has said every transitional fossil supposedly that's been found could fit on this particular table. And so what should be found is the majority, almost all of the fossil record should be transitional fossils. But what we find out of the billions upon billions of fossils, with extraordinarily rare exceptions, and so they should be interpreted by what's found, is everything fully formed, fully filled, no transitional fossils, none. And so the few that are disputed that possibly would be interpreted, it's all the prism you're looking at. If you say, I am an evolutionist, let me look for evidence. Oh, we found a few possible transitional fossils. Whereas if you're looking at objectivity, which is true, what is the true theory, then you would reject that out of hand. You would interpret the many billions over the few scraps, you know. And then you would say the few scraps have to somehow fit into the few billions. Through the worldwide flood, through different breakings, through abnormalities. I mean, people, animals, people are born with handicaps and abnormalities just because of sin in the world and genetic structure. And so that could have happened with certain fossils as well. Okay, so Kirkus Reviews, the Evening Standard says a lucid, elegantly written, and thought-provoking social and intellectual history. The Spectator, which I enjoy The Spectator a lot, hugely enjoyable. Wilton picks Darwin's contradictions with a scientist's forensic skill and a novelist's imaginative touch. And then The Times says, as a historian trying to put Darwin in the context of his time, there's surely no better biographer than Wilson. And then about Freud, we have even Slate. Now, Slate would be extremely, let's face it, it's not left-leaning. It is a leftist publication. I'm pointing to the right. Leftist publication. And so Laura Miller of Slate says this, shrewd, incisive, Freud, The Making of an Illusion is a closely argued indictment intended to definitively bury what Cruz regards as the myth of Freud as an innovative and insightful thinker. By the time he's done, the legendary Viennese doctor has been reduced to not much more than a rag, a bone, and a hank of hair. Okay, National Review, which I really like National Review. Now, when I say I really like something, like I'll read things from Slate, I just wouldn't normally agree with their viewpoint. National Review, same way. I'd like a lot on National Review, but I wouldn't agree with everything on there. E. Fuller Torrey of National Review says this, the culmination of more than 40 years of research, it is doubtful whether it will be surpassed as a scholarly work on Freud as a person on the origin of his ideas. New York Review of Books says a cuss word and mesmerizing by turns. Okay, Frank J. Soloway, author of Freud, Biologist of the Mind Beyond the Psychoanalytic Legend, says this, this riveting and masterful reassessment puts the final nail in the coffin of Sigmund Freud's misguided career by meticulously documenting his willful descent into pseudoscience. Altogether a fascinating read. So, and it's published, let's see, the Darwin book is published by HarperCollins. Let's see who published this book. This is published by Picador, which, forgive my ignorance, I am just not acquainted with Picador. Let's read these quotes in here. Friedrich Nietzsche, however far human beings may reach with their knowledge, however objective they may seem to themselves to be, in the end they carry away nothing but their own biography. I like Nietzsche in a lot of ways. It's not a lie if you believe it. That's George Costanza on Seinfeld. All right, that's a lot of illustrations in here. Again, I've done separate kind of previews on both these books, but you know, I'd recommend, even if you're a Freudian psychoanalyst and you worship Freud, even if you're a Darwinian to the very core of your bones, you owe it to yourself. You know, I read many books. Like, I would be a Oneness Pentecostal, and I've tried to read every Trinitarian argument and every Trinitarian book ever written, because I want to make sure that what I see in Scripture is correct. And it is usually only served to reinforce my belief in a biblical view of God and historical view of God. And so some people just don't like to have their beliefs challenged and that cognitive disruption and all this. So Freud and The Making of an Illusion by Cruz and Darwin by A.N. Wilson. I'm more acquainted with A.N. Wilson than I am Frederick Cruz. I'm so sorry that I don't know that much about these two particular authors. So anyhow, God bless. We'll talk with you later in Jesus' name. Just believe the book. You'll be all right. In Jesus' name, amen.